You're watching BlackTree on TV, only on Soul of the South.
Welcome back, y'all. This is BlackTree on TV. I'm your girl, Alex Hudgens, and we're back to keep you up to date on all things Hollywood. Now, it's hard to believe some of the stories that have circulated about one of the all-time best rap groups ever, A Tribe Called Quest. You would think that a rap group that created such harmonious music would be a crazy solid fam. Well, not exactly. We caught up with Phife Dawg, who is willing to talk.
I would say that Tribe Called Quest was definitely the fathers of a whole new brand of hip-hop.
They completely mastered the form and culture of what hip-hop is supposed to be.
Up to then, rap was maybe more about like boasting. They came out and it was like party records, but doing it with a consciousness.
Everything about that was magic.
Like a
phone
check, 1, 2, 1, 5.
Nothing was touching Tribe, nothing.
I've known Q-Tip since we were about 2 years old.
We met in church, best friends, you know what I'm saying? He was the one who said to me, yo, you should rhyme. And if you could rhyme, that was like a big deal.
Then he had met Ali in high school, and before you know it, it was on.
You had one voice that was high.
A little high-pitched voice. I hated my voice.
And then you had Tip, who was like in the middle.
And that was always a dynamic.
The yin and yang of those two, that to me was the perfect marriage.
Oh, can I kick it? These are the drums.
The reason why I made the movie is because in 1998, when they did break up, I was curious, why did you break up? And will you get back together? And I had no idea the intensity of their relationships. I had no idea of the sort of fractured dysfunction at time of their relationships. And I mean that in a not judgmental way, because I've had my own share of personal relationships that are fractured. Yeah. We all do. And I think the dynamic and the dichotomy of this great music that people still have a longing and excitement about, and this sort of, you know, internal strife, makes for, you know, good storytelling.
Well, I was the last member that he approached, actually. And my first response or question to him was, what did the rest of the guys say? And they were with it. So I was like, all right, cool, I'm with it. Now, as far as what I thought was gonna be involved in the film or shown, when you say the word documentary, I'm thinking good, bad, and different. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I was cool with it. I was game. I was ready for it. Oh, wow. Back in New York, the station of choice was 107.5 WBLS, as well as 98.7 KISS. And just Mr. Magic being on WBLS and Red Alert being on KISS, whatever they played, it was like, yeah, I want to be a part of that. But I'm from the same neighborhood as LL and Run DMC, so I definitely wanted to be like them.
They had everything. You know, they had it. It was a group. They had a back and forth. They had a great chemistry between Q-Tip and Phife. Their voices were different. They looked different. The things that they were talking about were very different. The way they were talking about them, there was a, you know, an honesty and a humor and a vulnerability in the music. And with their music, you know, it was in the intangible quality, I think, about their music that was unique, was it was for everybody.
Wow, apparently it ain't always easy being in a band or a group. Still love me some Tribe Called Quest, but can't help but think a little differently now. Still ahead, we're giving you an exclusive first look at the new horror flick, Deliver Us From Evil. Don't miss it next on BlackTree on TV, your number one source for urban entertainment.
You're watching BlackTree on TV, only on Soul of the South.